Hi guys, I'm back. Frankie Pozos here to do another cool review for you. I know it's been a while, and I always say that in every video that it's been a while, but let's cut to the chase. I got some cool stuff I want to show you, and let's do it. What I got you probably read on top of the title screen there. I'm going to show you, I got the 1960s Batman cowl. I did. I bought it from Mattel. It was a crazy buy. I don't know. I saw the review from Pixel Dan, and I was like, I need to buy that, and so I purchased it. All right, so when you get it in the mail, you get it in a couple boxes. One giant box, and then inside that giant box, you got this box, the classic Mattel guy that's in that, and says Batman, classic TV series, the cowl. And then inside this box, there is the Bat cowl. But it's just very weird that Mattel does that. There's so many boxes, like the Hoverboard did that, and there was another box, and it just feels like it's a Russian doll thing. But either or, I mean, it just sucks because I'm not going to keep it this box, but I want to because it's cool. I don't know. Anyway, let's go to the badass box. Here you go. Batman. Pow! Look at that. Is it Robin? They're shaking hands. And then, boom. Look at that. I should have started with that. I messed up the whole thing. And then right behind it has cool talking thingies. It says, the infamous cowl is not only protection for Batman's head, but serves as a disguise to keep his identity as a millionaire playboy, Bruce Wayne, under wraps. The high-performance headgear even marked him as a target for the one and only Mad Hatter at the headdress ball, who temporarily turned it bright pink. Whoa, that should have a variant of that. That'd be cool. And now that's a hip headpiece. All right, so here you go. So ready to open this amazing kick-ass box. I was going to do the Superman theme, and that'd be ridiculous. Look at that. There it is. So inside the box, then you take it out very ever so gently. And boom. So here is the Batman cowl, the Adam West 1960s Batman cowl. Alright, so, I mean, if you've seen Pixel Dan's review, you know, it talks about this as... It's hard, you can hear that. It's cool designs. The color, I mean, it's a dark blue. It's not exactly the dark, dark blue that you sometimes get to see with a lot of the Adam West Batman outfits and stuff. So, it's not that color, so that might be an issue for some. I think it's cool. I think it's overly heightened, maybe stylized, and that I like that sense. Also, yeah, the eyebrows here, if you're like a, you know, one of those pickety persons, you see that these guys are not that close, I believe, but I have no issues because it's really freaking cool. So, let's try on this sucker. First off, this bad boy comes with, this Velcro guy, this cool Velcro guy that, I mean, it's designed probably for kids, so you can put it on their heads so they could fit. But my head's gigantic. Not because I'm smart, but just because I'm an ogre, you know? But I like this guy. I'm not going to use it, but I could have it as a neck thing. But I got that. Alright, that's not funny, and I'm probably upsetting you. So, let's get ready to become Batman. Alright, it just happens. Okay, I'm going to do it, like, off-side, like, so you just see my neck. Alright, I'm getting ready. And then... So, ultimately, this head fits awesome. Even though I took out the little Velcro guy there, it doesn't feel like, you know, you do a bike helmet and you take out that stuff and then you put your head on it and it doesn't have the padding and it hurts. No, it doesn't hurt. It feels good. And it comes with this little guy that you can make it more costumey and cool. Just make sure you got the right pin there. I mean, the button there, and then the button there, and then the button there, and then the button there. And then, boom, you're Batman. You're just walking around. Like... up, yeah, I forgot my outfit, but I'm Batman. Or you just be, hey guys, you need Batman, but I need to get my outfit, you know. So it's pretty cool. I really like this. This is one of the coolest things I ever purchased. I have to be perfectly honest with you. I mean, I don't want to take this off right now, but it's just so cool. And you're just like, and your head can move. It doesn't bob around. It doesn't feel awkward. That's what I like about it. I mean, yeah, I could go to a prop guy, he can make this, probably $400, $500, which, I mean, yeah, there you go, goes to a guy, you know, but ultimately it would probably hurt, there'll be little areas where it pinches and feel awkward. This is mass-produced, it's a manufactured by Mattel, so it's safe. So if there's any weird toxic thing on this that gives me cancer, I could probably sue them and make some money. Or they'll just let me die. And I'll try to sue them, and then they'll just keep the court going, and then I'll eventually shrivel up and die. But ultimately, I feel this is a good purchase. You can buy it at MattyCollector.com, I believe. That's a site. And it's $100. Hopefully no one's hearing me that I spent $100 on it. Please don't tell anybody. My family, my friends. Please don't say I spent $100 on a 1960s Batman cowl. Dude, I wasn't even born when this show was on, but I have a Batman cowl for that show, which is pretty cool. I mean, next up, I need to buy the car, but that'll be down the road, you know. But, so, there you go. It's pretty cool. The ears, I mean, they're little, you know, they're stiff, they're hard, I mean, they're durable. Everything's pretty good. Nothing feels like, oh, if I touch that too much, it's gonna break. That's the greatest thing about this. I mean, so, down bottom line, if you're a person that just wants a Batman cowl, a safe purchase that you can buy it through a site that you can, you know, get your money back if any issues, boom, Mattel. I mean, but ultimately, if you're a purist, that you care that this brow is kind of not perfect and that the color scheme is not 100%, then I recommend go and find a prop guy who's going to make the greatest thing ever. And I mean, you can find that on forums and everything. But I give it a thumbs up. I'm going to put this on display or just wear it all the time. So if you see in the news some crazy guy pestering people or, yeah, in a Batman cowl, well, that's me. Frankie Pozos. Well, thank you guys for watching, and I'll have more crazy stuff, a lot more new high-end insane stuff coming up soon, so keep on watching, and my name's Frankie, and I'll be back. I will be back, because you need me.